Hey Lady Vol fans, I'm Cassandra Novi and this is Lady Vol Access, your behind the scenes source for everything Tennessee basketball. On this week's show, we'll preview the Lady Vol's SEC tournament campaign, get to know junior guard Megan Simmons, and then wrap things up with another look inside the numbers. Right now, we are pleased to be joined with sophomore forward Sierra Burdick. And Sierra, first of all, I would like to congratulate you and the team on the SEC regular season title. What does it mean to you guys to get that regular season championship title when you guys were picked to finish fourth and fifth, you know, in the preseason?
I think it's a great feeling. Obviously, we're not settling with the regular season championship, but I mean, that was one of the goals that we set in the beginning of the season. So just to reset, I mean, it is an accomplishing feeling, and you know, it feels good to kind of prove all those non-believers and doubters wrong who picked us fifth in the SEC, to show them that, hey, we're better than what you guys projected us to be, and we are worthy of our number one spot.
And you guys head to the SEC tournament this weekend. How are you guys preparing for this, since you will be playing, you know, back-to-back days whenever you're normally used to having, you know, a couple of days off between games?
I think the biggest thing is just getting off of our feet after games. Obviously, we want to do what we can to get the win, and sometimes it's going to take 30 minutes of play, sometimes it's going to take 40 minutes of play, but you know, we've just got to be smart with it and utilize our trainers, J-Mo and Matea, and do all the treatment that we can to be able to play back-to-back like that.
All right, great. Thank you.
Thank you, Sam.
Junior Megan Simmons was just honored as the SEC's Co-Player of the Year. Let's learn more about Tennessee's offensive spark and this week's player feature.
An explosive shooting guard that plays to electrify the Lady Vol faithful. Tennessee's Megan Simmons scores the basketball.
For a three, that's off the front of the rim, no good. Simmons with a rebound. Simmons drives it down the right side, lays it up, good. Three. Now in front court, Simmons left wing for a three, good. To five, Tennessee by 14. Simmons, same spot, same shot, same result.
I'm a scorer, so that's just one of the things that I was given a gift for. And I have the tendency to pick up a tempo of the game at any point in time. I can be a game changer at any point in time, just with me getting a steal or me making a three or doing a good pass or something like that. But that's really just my weapon, and just bringing a lot of energy, getting the fans involved and things like that.
She can score the basketball in so many different ways, and sometimes she'll make shots and we just don't know how she did it. And she just plays hard, she practices hard, and she's just talented. It's just a gift.
Massengale dribbles right, off to Simmons. Simmons on the baseline, puts up the floater. Graves with a rebound. Outlet pass comes to Simmons. Simmons drives the right side, shot off the glass. Good by Simmons.
I always just think about it going in.
It's 2 points. It's going in every time. Every time when she gets a steal or she attacks the basket, I think it's going in, and I think she does too, and I think we all do.
Coaches always tell me, you know, when I get one, they want me to get more. So that's always my mindset, is to try to get another one, because when I do that, it's like a domino effect and everybody else gets involved, and the energy is just live, and the aura of the game is just amazing.
The junior from Cibolo, Texas only knows one way to lead: by example.
We tell Megan all the time that we feed off of her energy, and when she's positive and upbeat and has that energy, it literally just spreads to all of us. And we look to her, and she is a leader vocally, and more so just a leader by example. When she's playing hard and when she has that positive energy, it just spreads to everybody.
I lead by example more because, you know, I'm not like a confrontational type of player. I like to, you know, talk to my teammates, you know, encourage them, make sure, you know, they're staying on their toes and make sure they're out there doing the right thing.
Simmons' fast-paced playing style has her averaging a league-leading 19.6 points per game. Not bad for the player who's her own worst critic.
Make my team proud, honestly. I would say make sure I'm doing everything that is expected of me, and making sure that within the course of the game, not only doing what everybody expects of me, but doing the things that I know I'm capable of doing.
Megan Simmons, one of the vital reasons the Lady Vols have clinched at least a share of the regular season SEC championship for the 17th time. For the Holly Warlick Show, I'm Evan Ellis.
With the SEC tournament this weekend, let's take a look inside the numbers at the history of Tennessee's postseason play. Tennessee has won the past three SEC tournaments, which means the Lady Vols carry a 9-game league tournament winning streak into this year's event. Through the years, the Lady Vols have amassed a 69-17 record in league postseason play and claimed a total of 16 SEC tournament trophies. It's been 33 years since head coach Holly Warlick was a senior point guard who guided Tennessee to a sweep of SEC regular season and tournament titles in 1980. Well, the regular season has come to a close, and so has this episode. As a reminder, you can watch the final Holly Warlick Show of the season this weekend. Check your local listings to see when it will air on your Lady Vol Network channel. The Lady Vols begin tournament play Friday at noon when they take on the winner of the Arkansas-Florida game. The game will be shown on Sports South. Thanks for joining us on this week's Lady Vol Access. I'm Cassandra Novi, and we'll see you next week.